All right, so the chase is about to get underway. We're second in terms of the playoff points because I think we had the second most wins behind Brad Keselowski, which will help us because we started 15th here at Chicagoland. And we're going to see if we can win and get into the next round because that's the name of the game in the chase. Just win, baby. So, as I try to find the running order for you guys.
Stay low. Still there.
Oh, we're going to... Well, now Ryan Newman actually wrecked me in qualifying. And the fact that the yellow took that long to come out is absolutely unacceptable. But we knew that already. So what we're going to do is we're going to pit. We're going to get four tires and fuel and hopefully start to work some strategy on the rest of the field. Certainly the front runners, who only two of them are pitting. All right, so starting last, like I said, Ryan Newman wrecked me in qualifying and not really a surprise that he wrecked me again. Probably the reason I was starting back there in the first place was because of Ryan Newman wrecking me. But regardless, we're back to green. And hopefully this time a little bit more clean than last time. We'll actually make a lap, maybe. All right, so around the outside, car feeling pretty nice, though everything's gonna tighten up here on the back straightaway. So that's the problem with like the safer barriers at Chicagoland. They come out really close to the wall, or really close to the actual racing line. So when you're entering the corners, and for that matter, exiting the corners, the safers are always right there. If I was designing this track, I would knock down the walls that are existing and just put safers up and kind of restore the racetrack to its former width, because this is just, it's a little bit tight. As you can see right there, as I just scraped the safer coming out of turn two, I don't think you can get much closer than that. I'm going to bail out of it here underneath Clint Bowyer and behind Bobby Labonte. Really nowhere to go. And now Trevor Bayne's going to sneak to the inside, our fastest lap of the race, but not faster than we went in qualifying, obviously, because we were trapped in traffic most of the lap. But this time, as we go around the outside, we should be able to clear these folks. Unless Tony Stewart decides to be a bit annoying to pass. But it looks like we're able to get around him, out of the outside of Eric Jones. Hard on the throttle, a little bit wide there in turn number three. They've got a bit of a three-wide deal going on here with McFlurry and Allmendinger and Paul Menard. And again, I had to be careful going into turn three, or turn one, excuse me, because of that darn safer barrier out there. Feels like it's like, you know, like a 90-degree wall. Ugh. And there's the worst part of the NASCAR heat physics. That is the worst part of the NASCAR heat physics, is the fact that you cannot touch a car side to side on the straightaway at all. Otherwise you're going around. But here we come up to Flying Ryan here, the guy who's been such a pain in my rear end this weekend, and we're hoping to get around him. I think he's in the chase. I think most of the people in this top half of the field are in the chase, so we're racing all these guys. I think Blaney, I don't know if Blaney got in the chase. I should have checked this before I started racing, but frankly, I was only concerned about my position, and I was like, oh, okay, I'm in the chase. Let's go for it. So we're going to run the apron here. It's a bit of a qualifying line, but screw it. We ran our fastest lap of the race once again. And now we're, once the field is spread out here a bit, now we can really go to work here, making moves, making passes, getting up to the front of the field. We also have fuel on board, which is another thing that's going to be very important come the end of this one, or at least come the end of the first stint, because we're going to be able to get out front and hopefully stay out front.
That was a great lap.
As we go faster and faster as we work our way up to speed here at the Chicagoland Speedway. Only time you race here in the NASCAR season. As we dive down to the inside of Casey Kane. Or maybe I should say William Byron. Just get used to that for the inevitable NASCAR Heat 2 Daytona 500 pack that they'll come out with. And as we work down the main straightaway, again setting our fastest lap of the race, again doing it in traffic, even though it was only one car we had to pass that time, getting right down next to the white line. It's a very nice line through turns 1 and 2. And now in the draft of Kevin Harvick. Don't know where Keselowski is. Keselowski's kind of the wild card, because he's the guy who has the most points, just in general and in terms of the playoff points. So all of those things adding up to the fact that we need to beat Brad Keselowski at every single one of these rounds, regardless of whether we're, you know, winning races or just pointing against Keselowski, because that's the guy who has the lead in the chase standings. So let's see if we can get around the outside of Kevin Harvick here. Car is hooking up really well. We definitely have a better handle on the track than the AI do. So we're gonna get all the way down here on the apron. And right next to the grass there. Come up the track and cheat our way around Kevin Harvick and Dale Jr. So that's two cars down. Harvick was unhappy with my cheating, but he can go have happy words about Dale Jr. with Dale Jr. Talk about, you know, all of his feelings about Dale Jr. and most of them will probably be right, despite the fact that Junior Nation probably won't like to hear it. Here we go, down to the inside. We're gonna try this again. Another cheater line going on. And into turn one, I guess we'll follow Kurt Busch in there. And sneak around Martin Truex. And now get in the draft, and to the inside of Kurt Busch. Get around him, and then set our sights on Joey Logano. We're just methodically moving up. This is fantastic.
Miller, all clear.
Of course, I'm expecting lap cars to start playing a factor here, but we haven't seen them yet. I assume we'll see more of them as pit stops start to cycle through and the field gets even more spread out. So it looks like maybe Edwards is leading the race at the moment. It's definitely an orange car. It's possible somebody has a different paint scheme for this race. But generally speaking, there's not a lot of orange cars that run up at the front. And certainly in this game, Carl Edwards is in an orange car. So down to the inside of Joey Logano, we'll get that move done and accomplished. Right down next to the white line once again, running just a really good line. I have to say, I'm making it work here at Chicagoland, which is better than I usually end up having. Certainly better than the last race at Richmond. That is for certain sure. And now we're taking a look at four cars out in front. Chase Elliott, Denny Hamlin, maybe Kyle Busch, and then Carl Edwards. And indeed, that is the four. Three Toyotas and a Chevrolet. And then, of course, my Toyota, which started the season as a Ford, but then I sold out to Comcast just in the hopes that I get the purple Xfinity car before the end of the NASCAR Heat Evolution Career Mode, which is in 9 races, and then we can move on to NASCAR Heat 2, where that is going to be interesting, even though you can't race a Dodge. Ah, what a shame. I wonder if they tried to get the Dodge license and just couldn't, or if they didn't even try. But I think we're getting some pit stops here, because everybody was running very low on the track, and indeed, the 4 leaders pit before I can pass them on track. But that doesn't matter, because we now get to lead this thing by a country friggin' mile. Now time to try to run some nice, consistent, fast laps here. I do feel the tires wearing just a little bit. Had to kind of breathe it in the middle of the corner there, because I was kind of worried I was going to spear into the outside wall. Just a little bit more breathing. Car's starting to work its way up the track. And very nice. So what kind of a lap time do we run here? Up to, well, down to a 32 from a 31, but again, worn tires. To be expected, a little bit of a fall off there. Car just washing up the banking. I guess I just need to lift more often into the corner, or earlier on. Then let's get her down there. Kind of hit minimum speed in the middle of the corner and then accelerate off, but that time I was quite slow, and Jimmy Johnson, the car directly behind me, was gaining, but I believe he's now popped into the pits, so we are now out by our lonesome, which is fine with me. Funny that we have not caught any lap cars yet. We must be so far out in front of the race that we have not only... Or it's possible the lap cars haven't pitted yet. I hadn't even considered that option.
Are you low on fuel?
Since I'm low on fuel, I haven't gotten an alarm yet. So we're going to stay out, despite the fact that I got distracted because it said I'm low on fuel. There's the alarm. Okay. So we'll come in at the end of this lap. And there are the lap cars. I was wondering where they are, and indeed, there they are. So Austin Dillon is the only car that has not made a pit stop yet, and it appears like he is now in the pits. So we're going to lift off the gas on the brakes, because
you
can never use the brakes in this game properly, and again...
Slow down.
Wow. Wow, that was the slowest pit entry ever. We got held up by Austin Dillon as well. So four tires, full of fuel. Gonna get back out there and keep a rolling. Not sure where we're gonna actually cycle out. That looks like the lap car's coming through, and that's Jimmy Johnson going by, so we've at least lost position to Jimmy Johnson. Let's see how far we actually go, and it sounds like the yellow is out. Nope. Usually when you hear the click of the radio like that, it means the yellow is out, but apparently not.
Yellow down.
There it is. I knew it. All right, so ready to go back to green here. We're starting in the sixth position. And I think this is a good shot here to take the lead.
There's the green flag.
I guess you could call that the end of the stage. Stage one winner, Denny Hamlin.
Still there.
And now Kyle Busch leads the race. It's like an Xfinity race.
Carlo.
The Xfinity race has broken out here in the first race of the Monster Energy Sprint Cup, whatever, Winston Cup chase.
Still there.
We caught the safer barrier there, and here we go again.
The yellow's out.
stupid physics. Terrible. Okay, 35th. Martin Truex was a lap down for some reason. Not sure why. But he got the free pass, so he's no longer a lap down. Starting on the inside, which is not the best place to be in the world. As we saw from the first yellow flag of the day. It's like you can't even start up front in this game. Because of all the bad, A, the bad physics, and B, the rubber banding AI. Terrible. I'm so hoping they fixed it, but I don't think that, what on the God's green earth was that?
There's trouble in turn three.
Somebody want to explain that one to me? That was just the most stupid thing I've ever seen in my entire life. That's genuinely broken physics. Somebody please try to defend that. Oh, and the car is so loose now. Because the rear end is damaged. Look at that. Oh, God. How bad is the rear end? Oh, yeah. Oh, dear. Deary me. I have every feeling that I should just restart the race now, but we're going to keep going. Fully expecting there to be another stupid caution, but good grief, really? Look, I can't even turn the car anymore. Can't even make it through the tri-oval anymore. Oh dear. Oh dear. Well, okay, we're back to at least a car that I can pass.
Miller.
Maybe.
Clear
just, I cannot drive the car the same way as I was, which is very aggressive. And now, see, even if I make a move out of the groove at all now, it's like the car just wants to spin the entire way around. Let's try and spin in the tri-oval. I had to be so precise with my movements to not, you know, just pinch it down in. It's funny, the car being this loose is actually going to probably help it over the long run when the tires wear, is going to almost lose it again. But having the rear end completely trashed on the car is not very helpful. As you can see, it's a nightmare to try to control. And we're past the halfway mark. I think I may have been silently fuming, and thus has that part has been cut out of the video. But we did hit the halfway point. So we've got, you know, a few more cars to pass here. Just gotta keep saving the car. Thank God they just paved literally everything on this track. It's like Phoenix. You just go wherever you want, and there are no consequences for your actions. And we are still just mired in the back. There's nothing I can do except for just hold on to the car and hope the yellow comes out. Which I can hopefully expect to happen when the cars pit, because that always happens. Or just bring it out myself. Oh, for the love of God. We got one shot at this, and I missed it.
There's a wreck in turn two.
Oh no, what happened? Oh no, I'm stuck in gear. What's going on? I appear to be trapped in gear. I can't move. What's going on? Oh no! What a crash! Oh, I'm the first car lapped down. Wonder what's gonna happen. Well, I guess Denny Hamlin's gonna run to the back. Oh, I got the free pass. What a surprise. What a wonderful, happy surprise.
The race is going green.
Okay. We're just gonna let him go. Just screw that. We're gonna go to the outside when we get a chance here. And hopefully they spread out a little bit. Alright, so into one and two. No real trouble. Now down the backside, we got a big run here on Annette. And I've gone and done that, which was exactly what I shouldn't have been doing. But it's better to aim for the wall in this game than to aim for an AI car, because the AI car will absolutely spin you out, as we have seen at least two times in this video so far. Okay, so through and around turn number two.
Carlos.
Do not do anything stupid, Ryan Newman. Do not do anything stupid.
Miller.
We completely wrecked the car again on the outside. Miller. Still haven't had any friggin' position gain.
You're all clear.
There we go.
Miller.
Yeah, I definitely will. Why does the safer barrier even go away right there?
Carlo.
There's literally no reason for it to go away there, and yet it does.
Carlo. Miller.
Just holding on for dear life out here. You gotta focus so intently on not smacking the bloody wall. That you just have to, like, or another car. Really, it's not touching another car. That is the key.
They so have
20 laps
Miller.
To go.
Carlos.
And we're starting to make some moves now. We've kind of gotten out of the really silliness. And the field's starting to spread out a little bit. So as long as they're at most two wide deep into the corners, I think we'll be all right now. Good job to Benedetto, 18th. And there's Keselowski, first time we've seen him all day. So that is where he is. That is who we need to beat, at least early on here in the chase. So trying to hang it around the outside, not working particularly well, though we're going to get a good run
Stiller.
On Chase Elliott there, but there was nowhere to go. And Kyle Larson going very slowly. We got cars hitting. I almost wrecked off of Chase Elliott there. Keselowski back to the inside. He will gain that position back. That's interesting that everybody's pitting. Wonder exactly how this is all going to work out, but as you can see, we've got at least Landon Castle coming into the pits. Not sure about the rest of these guys. Screw off, David Reagan.
Still there. All clear. Car
come some cars into the pits. Not Keselowski, though, so we're going to have to battle with Keselowski. No doubt about it. And Carl Edwards just up there. Maybe it's one of the petty cars. It's possible it's Brian Scott, who is running this far up in the field. Carl Edwards is trying to get around him, but again, Brian Scott doing a pretty good job right now, to say the least, running in fourth. And is he going to peel off into the pits? No, he's not. Brian Scott leads the motor race, or not leads, but he's running third, which for Brian Scott, it might as well be a
yellow down.
And there is the yellow. That, yeah, we're going to pit, and we're going to make it to the end on fuel, I believe, after this. And yes, you can see Brian Scott is fourth. Okay, so we fell all the way back to 25th, so I'm guessing there's some cars that were on the lead lap that did not pit. So we've got a nice jumbled up order here, but the good thing is we've got the outside lane for the restart. We've got 12 laps to finish this one. And apparently hit the wall on this one. Well, that was not what I wanted to do. See, there it is. There it is again. Better be a yellow. Better throw a yellow.
There's a wreck in turn three.
There. It already has me a lap down. I don't know why that is. Whatever, screw it. Okay, we got the free pass, so whatever, it doesn't matter. 30th place, so we're only 5 positions lower than we were on the last restart. So, here we go. I'm going to try to not put it in the wall here in turn one. That's what really hurt me. We got back to the green. Let's try to get to the... Well, I guess they're just going to pull away here. I'm just going to hold it. Got to be patient. Rather than completely...
Stay hot.
Nuts here. Here we go. Alright, you want to get nuts? Let's get nuts. There we go. Four wide pass there. Fantastic runoff of turn number four. All the way down the middle of the front straightaway. Still got 6 laps to go. So a good opportunity to get some points here. Even if the outright win is out of the question. There it is again. Well, I thought I was going to get good points. Try it again. 30th place is not where we need to be. It's just so stupid. Oh.
5 laps to go.
Alright, 5 to go. Can we do anything with this? Let's try. Run in the outside groove as best I can.
Stay hot. Still there.
Silently going down the back stretch because focus in on not doing what I just did. Have I passed anybody yet? No, I haven't. Casey Mears is the next car to pass. Very nearly got taken out by Danica there. But whatever. Alright, nice run around the outside here. Nobody pulls up in front of me. Nobody's pulling up in front of me until Trevor Bayne, who's not even car. I'm racing for position. Thank God I didn't hit the wall there. I mean, I hit the wall, but I didn't, like, scrape off of it, which would have slowed my car down unrealistically. Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go. Three laps to settle it. And there they go, they're wrecking. But they didn't wreck fully, so we're gonna stay green. Oh, that was interesting.
Still there.
We're out of the outside of Regan Smith.
All clear.
A lot of lap cars up here in the mix. That's interesting. Almirola.
Two to go.
Two laps to go. Austin Dillon. We should be able to get around him fairly easily. And then on the flying Ryan here.
Still there.
Every point matters if we're not gonna make it in with a win, at least after this race.
Still there. All clear.
Come on. We're gonna have one lap to go here. We're gonna have a couple cars. It looks like we'll be able to pass fairly easily. David Reagan, we should be able to pass.
Last lap.
Kyle Larson, we should be able to get around.
Still there.
Hold it around the outside if we can.
Still
able to do so. Ryan Blaney up there now. It looks like he may be the last car I'm able to actually pass here. As we go up and down the field all day, gonna stick it up maybe to 14th if we can get around, and we do. So 14th place.
That's worth a few points.
For the first race of the chase, not exactly where I wanted to be. So 14th in the race, it is what it is. Greg Biffle, lap down. I think, Jimmy Johnson's a chaser, so that's at least one out of the race. The Gibbs guy is absolutely dominant. Absolutely dominant. Brian Scott with a good finish, too. Money, not going to be too good. Going to be $300,000, and that's going to be it. $300,000 and some change. So, let's take a look at the points. Edwards has already advanced. We are... in terms of points, 8th. Keselowski 2nd, because he had all them playoff points. Not too bad. We're ahead of, you know... well, we're smack dab in the middle of the chase. So, you know, it is what it is at this point. Edwards is in, and we've got to get in. So let's head back to the race shop, see if there's anything else pressing to take a look at. Brian Scott actually finished 11th. Now we move on to New Hampshire. Oh, God. Yeah. New Hampshire. That's not going to be good.